Good afternoon, students. In the previous class, to say a particular compound as aromatic, that compound must follow following rules like that. Three rules I told. First one, planar. Planar, it should be planar structure. Second one, it should follow conjugation. And third one, 4n plus 2 pi electron rule. Okay. All these rules, if a compound is going to follow, then that compound is called aromatic compound like that we have seen. Okay. These aromatic compounds, aromatic hydrocarbons, are two types, benzenoids and non-benzenoids. Aromatic hydrocarbons are of two types, those are benzenoids and non-benzenoids. The compounds which are called aromatic hydrocarbons, and those structures are resembling like structure of benzene, those are called benzenoids. Example, benzene, naphthalene, anthracene, these are the aromatic compounds in which they contain cyclic hexagon rings. Cyclic hexagon rings are present. Ma. They are resembling like benzene structures. That's why these are all coming under benzenoids. Okay. Non-benzenoids. They cannot, those structures means those are not contained by cyclic hexagon rings. Example. Cyclopropanoyl cation. Cyclooctatrienyl cation, these are all aromatic hydrocarbons only, but they are not like hexagon rings, so they are not like benzene compounds. Those are not looking like benzene compounds. Those are all called non-benzenoids. These are all benzenoids. Okay, ma'am. This is simple thing under classification of aromatic hydrocarbons. Those are benzenoids and non-benzenoids. So till now, which type of compounds are called aromatic compounds we understood. Next thing, scientists, how did they obtain the structure of benzene? That one we want to explain. So we need to see structure and isomerism in benzene, as well as IUPAC nomenclature also we will see. Okay, first we will see that our side heading is, after completion of the rules in which type of compounds are aromatic, our side heading is structure of benzene. One small thing, till now any compound, if you take any compound also, we are not able to see that compound even with the help of electron microscope. With the help of electron microscope, we are able to get blurred image of that compound only. That is also, the compound must be big. Then only we are able to see that one. At that condition, in old days, then how did they get the structure of benzene? Like that, for any compound, it is difficult only. Okay. But here, the thing is, structure, by using the molecular weight experiment, molecular weight of benzene is 78. Like that, anyways, they got the molecular formula of benzene as C6H6. Initially, scientists, they got the molecular formula of benzene as C6H6. Okay. Now, how that C6H6 is present? Whether straight chain, all the carbons present in straight chain, it is not following alkenes, it is not following alkanes, it is not following alkynes general formula also. Any one of the general formula, it is not going to follow. Observe, CnH2n plus 2, it is not following. CnH2n means C6H12 must be there. But the molecular formula of benzene is C6H6. It is not following alkanes general formula, it is not following alkene's general formula, it is not following alkyne's general formula. Then scientists, they got one idea, that is, this type of compound is separately kept under one side heading, that is aromatic hydrocarbons, they kept later. Okay, but initially they treated this compound not like alkane, alkene or alkyne. Initially they treated this compound not like alkane, alkene or alkyne, because this compound is not following the general formula like alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. That is the first thing. So this is not coming under alkane or alkene or alkyne. That is the first thing. Okay. Now, scientists, they struggled so much to obtain the structure of this benzene, because even cyclic structure also, correctly, whether they are not able to get or not, they are going to check that one. So correctly, they are not able to get every time. Actually, it was given by Faraday. Faraday introduced the term benzene, but structure of benzene was explained by Kekulé. But structure of benzene was explained by Kekulé. Okay, then Kekulé finally, by doing different experiments, different types of things. Okay, I think you have watched that Spider-Man, huh? While that Spider-Man movie was going on, okay, he was bitten by that spider and he will get that powers. Okay, that powers means to give the web all these things, different powers he will get. After that, he doesn't want to show his face to human beings. Then he wants to take one structure in which it should be resembling like Spider-Man, as well as it should not, his face should not be known to others. Then he started drawing how the costume should be. Okay, like that, initially he has drawn some loose cloths like that. After that, he modifies that one, like the slow modifications, finally it results as one Spider-Man costume. Is it correct or not? Like that, here also, scientist Kekulé, he tried to give the structure of benzene. From starting onwards, he has drawn different structures. Okay, whether it is giving that property or not, like that, he checked everything he found. Finally, he came with one conclusion, like the Spider-Man costumes. Here also, Kekulé got one conclusion, structure for benzene, that is cyclic structure. Like this, he introduces the structure. Okay, every time this much time we won't take, because it is taking very much long time. So simply we are representing in a bond line representation this benzene as like this we are showing. Okay, so finally Kekulé got the structure of benzene by doing different experiments, and by trying with different structures like that, he has done all the experiments and finally he concluded the structure of benzene as like this. But this one is also not satisfying some properties. Okay, then he modified. What is the modification that he has done? All those things now we will discuss. Before that, this is the normal representation of benzene. Now this is called bond line representation. Now onwards, every time we will show benzene structure as like this only, because if you want to draw every reaction with benzene, this type, if you want to show, it will take so much time, unnecessary time waste. So we are going to be habituated to this structure, that is bond line representation of benzene. Okay, ma. Now how he got the idea of resonance, that one I'm going to say. According to that, he has drawn the resonance structures of benzene also. Okay, now let us see what about that explanation. Kekulé thought that this is one of the only one structure of benzene. This is the only one structure of benzene. He He thought that this is only one ben, one structure. Then this compound in which hydrogen present in that compound is substituted by bromine. Like that, two hydrogens are substituted. This is called dibromobenzene. Are you able to understand, ma? One more time. See here. Bromine present on first carbon, bromine present on second carbon. Okay, like that we are getting dibromobenzene. Two hydrogens are replaced by two bromines. This is called dibromobenzene. Okay, like this, one more is possible. This is also dibromobenzene. Okay, ma'am. Now, observe here the difference in first structure. Bromines are bonded to the carbons in which they are involved in double bond. In second compound, bromines are bonded to the carbons in which they are involved in single bond. Is it correct? Here, two possibilities of dibromobenzene we are getting according to Kekulé. Okay. That is, two bromines are present on the carbon which contains double bond. Two bromines present on the carbon which contains single bond. But practically, only one dibromobenzene will be formed. No two dibromobenzenes are there. Then how it is possible? Same benzene, sometimes double bond is present here. Immediately the double bond will be shifted to next carbon. Like that, double bonds are shifting from one place to another place. That idea he got, Kekulé. Actually, two dibromobenzenes Kekulé is getting. Those are dibromobenzene in which two bromines are present on carbon-carbon double bond, as well as two bromines are present on carbon-carbon single bond. Okay, but practically, how many times if you get dibromobenzene, we are getting only one dibromobenzene which is symmetrical, means it is not differentiated by any chemical properties. Then scientists, they concluded that it is possible with only one dibromobenzene, but Kekulé is giving two dibromobenzenes. Then finally, that Kekulé decided that those two are the structures of benzene only. Then how benzene will be existed in two structures? He found the new concept that is called resonance. Okay, ma'am. So same benzene can be happened in first structure as well as second structure. Now with the help of this dibromobenzene, I am going to get those structures, ma. Those two structures are these two are nothing but benzene only. Okay, if benzene is present in this form, it is able to form dibromobenzene with carbon-carbon double bond, bromine atoms present on carbon-carbon double bond. If benzene is in this form, we are getting bromine atoms present on carbon with single bond. Then he concluded, benzene is not present in one structure, benzene is present in two structures. Those two structures are also not fixed for benzene. Every time that pi bonds are getting moving from one form to one place to another place. So finally he concluded these are the resonance structures of benzene, and a new concept is arisen that is called resonance. Okay, now we have to see what about that resonance and what are the resonance forms of benzene we have to consider. clear explanation of resonance forms of benzene, we want to see ma. Okay, then how scientists came to this conclusion, did you understand ma? Kekule thought that 2 dibromo benzenes will be formed. Kekule thought that 2 dibromo benzenes will be formed. Then he found that naturally, practically, only 1 dibromo benzene is formed. No chance of 2nd dibromo benzene. Then he thought same benzene, okay, it is undergoing dibromination, in which 2 structures are possible because same benzene is existing in 2 different structures. Those 2 structures are this one. And he concluded one more point, that is that benzene will not be stable in any one position also. It will be changing from first form to second form, immediately second form to first form. Okay. And some more statements are there which is supporting the resonance structures of benzene. Those are, all the carbons in benzene will be getting same bond length. If only one structure is possible, that benzene contains single bond character as well as double bond character. But practically, all the carbons, all the bonds present in the benzene, 6 bonds, getting same bond length. Meaning, sometimes this single bond, sometimes it is double bond. Same bond is behaving like single bond and double bond because of continuous fluctuations, even that is not able to be recognized by X-ray diffractions. So it is behaving like one bond only. In between double bond and single bond, that X-ray diffractions techniques are thinking that that is getting only one bond character. That's why all the bonds, this is single bond, sorry, double bond, this is single bond. This is single bond, this is double bond. Like that, every bond is behaving like single bond as well as double bond in benzene. So all bonds are symmetrical. All bonds are symmetrical. Like that, one conclusion is there. At the time of resonance, I taught for you. Okay? Because of all these reasons, we are going to write the or draw the benzene structures as 2 structures. Ma? Those are 1 and 2, which are nothing but resonance structures of benzene. Which are nothing but resonance structures of benzene. Okay, na? Because all the bonds present in the benzene are identical. Same bond length they have, same strength they have. Okay. Like this we can conclude. And one more property is there, that is, normal alkene will undergo addition reaction to form normal alkene contains double bond, it will undergo addition reaction to form alkane. Benzene contains 3 pi bonds. Alkane contains pi bond. It will undergo addition reaction to form alkane. Alkene contains pi bond, 1 pi bond. It is undergoing addition reaction to form alkane. Like that, benzene contains 3 pi bonds. But benzene will not undergo addition reactions. Benzene will not undergo addition reactions. Why that benzene is not undergoing addition reactions? If it is undergoing addition reaction, that pi bond will be broken. Conjugation is gone down. When conjugation is gotten down, resonance it cannot show. If it is not able to show resonance, it will lose stability. Any molecule doesn't want to lose its stability. If any one of the double bonds present in benzene is lost, it is not going to be stable. It is going to lose the stability. Okay, that's why it wants to retain the double bonds like that only, without changing the double bonds, means without disturbing the double bonds. If any chemical properties are there, that benzene will undergo. By breaking the double bonds, it will not undergo reactions. That's why this is also one of the reasons we can say that those bonds are present in resonance. Resonance will give extra stability for benzene. That one now I am going to discuss with you, that resonance structures. Is it okay, ma? Now, all these statements, all the 6 bonds are identical. Okay, that dibromo benzene, we are getting 1 product only. But Kekule is explaining 2 structures. Finally, he only concluded that 2 resonance forms of benzene are possible. So, 2, it is possible like that I have drawn, but both are same only. Okay, and this one, benzene is not undergoing addition reactions like alkene. Like alkene, benzene is not undergoing addition reactions. Why? Because it is showing extra stability. Okay, by using the resonance term, we can explain all these things. That's why our next side heading is resonance of benzene. Is it okay, ma? We will go through that resonance of benzene. Till now, everything slowly it is explained. I hope you are clear only. Please concentrate on the topic which is going to be explained. Okay, ma? Now, let us continue. What about the resonance of benzene? Carbon present in benzene will undergo sp2 hybridization. Every carbon present in benzene will undergo sp2 hybridization. See, this carbon has three hybrid orbitals. One hybrid orbital is undergoing bond with hydrogen. This hybrid orbital undergoes another carbon hybrid orbital, which is sigma bond. This carbon is undergoing again sigma bond by sp2 hybridized hybrid orbital of first carbon and sp2 hybrid orbital of second carbon. Like that, all sigma bonds are present by undergoing between carbon and carbon, sigma bonds are formed by sp2 hybrid orbital of first carbon and sp2 hybrid orbital of second carbon. They will undergo complete overlapping. Like this, I can draw the structure of benzene, ma. Okay, but the problem is here, one unhybridized p orbital is present on every carbon. Every carbon has one unhybridized p orbital. One more time, carbon is undergoing 1s2, 2s1, 2p3. Excited state electronic configuration I am writing, ma. 1, 2, 3. Directly I am writing excited state electronic configuration. 1s2, 2s1, 2p3. Here it is undergoing sp2 hybridization only. Every carbon I wrote sp2 hybrid orbitals only. It is every carbon is remained with one unhybridized p orbital. Okay. The unhybridized p orbital will be present above the plane and below the plane. Suppose this is the plane. Here carbon is present. Carbon. All carbons are present and hydrogens also. All carbons and hydrogens are present in the plane. Then every carbon one unhybridized orbital is there. It is present above the plane and below the plane. Unhybridized p orbital. This carbon also contains one unhybridized p orbital. Like that, six pillars you can imagine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like that, six pillars we can imagine. Is it okay? Now, observe the condition carefully. This hybrid orbital, this unhybridized orbital contains one electron. Second carbon also contains one electron. First carbon electron spins in clockwise direction. Second carbon electron spins in anti-clockwise direction. Pi bond is present. Here pi bond is present. Next, these two. This one spins in clockwise, this one spins in anti-clockwise. They will be involved in pi bond. This one spins in clockwise and this one spins in anti-clockwise. These are also involved in pi bond. okay, like that three bibonds are present. At the same time, one of the electrons present here, one of the orbitals present here, electron is going to reverse the spin. When it is reversing the spin, this bond is broken and it will form bond with this one. When this one reverses the spin, it is going to form bond with this one and this bond is going to be broken. Then here this one is going to reverse the spin. At that time, this bond is going to be formed newly. And this is going to reverse the spin. Here we are going to get the bond here. Like that, old pi bonds are broken and new pi bonds are formed. Okay. In that way, pi bond is shifting from one position to another position. We are going to get new positions for pi bonds. Those are here we are getting here and here. After that, this process is reversed again. Again, it is getting its original structure. Actually, both are original structures only. It is getting its structure one. By breaking the pi bonds like that and newly formed pi bonds, it is changing from first bond, first structure to second structure. Again, second structure is changed to first structure by reversing the spins. Like that, every time the reverse process of spins are going to be happened, in which one structure is changed to second structure is changed to first structure continuously, frequently. These two are called resonance structures of benzene. Is it okay, ma? These two are called resonance structures of benzene. This one, while we are notating or while we are showing this notation, this is moving like this with arrow marks we will show. But actually, orbitals will be like that only. Electrons are reversing the spin because of that pi bond's location is going to be changed. Electrons are going to reverse that orientation, that spin, because of that. See, initially this is present here. When one of the electrons between these two is going to reverse the spin, then it is going to form bond with this one and this bond is going to be broken. It is going to form bond with this one. Like that, it is like a cyclic process. So pi bond is not present in one fixed position. It is changing from one position to another position. It is changing from one position to another position. That process is called delocalization. Localizer means fixed. Local people like that we will say. Local people means they are fixed in one position. From that position they will not move at all. That is called localization. Okay. Delocalization means the people which will roam from one place to another place. Like that here, pi bonds are moving from one position to another place easily, and that process is called delocalization. This delocalization of pi bonds, okay, because of this delocalization, some amount of energy will be lost by benzene. Already in the resonance structures I explained, while these electrons are going to reverse the spin, and again they are going to reverse to normal direction, clockwise to anticlockwise, and anticlockwise to clockwise, like that, while they are spinning the electrons, some amount of energy from the benzene ring is going to be lost out. When that benzene is going to lose the energy, then the benzene is getting more stable than our expectation. If it is present in one structure only, if that benzene is present in one structure only, okay, that benzene has internal energy, but it is present in another structure. Because of changing from one structure to another structure, it is going to lose the energy. Okay, when the substance has less energy, it will be more stable. When the substance has less energy, it will be more stable. Are you able to understand, my everyone? Please, clearly I am explaining everything by drawing the structures like this, and I am considering the clockwise and anticlockwise direction also. Please try to understand, everyone. When the electron present here, if it changes the spin, the bond here it is broken and it is new bond, it is going to be formed here. Then new bond, pi bond is present here. Previously pi bond is present here. When electron spin is changed, it is going to change its position. Like that, cyclic process happened. Again, this structure 2 is going to be changed to structure 1. Like this, structure 1 is changed to structure 2. Structure 2 is changed to structure 1. Like that, repetitionly, it is going to be happened. This is called, this process is called resonance. Because of this resonance, while it is converting from one structure to another structure, benzene is going to lose energy. Okay, that is called resonance energy or stabilization energy. While this electron is spinning in clockwise direction, it is going to change to anticlockwise. Again, anticlockwise direction to clockwise direction, some amount of energy will be lost by the total molecule, net amount of energy. Okay, that net amount of energy lost by the benzene is because of resonance structures. That net amount of energy, while it is converting from one form to another form and second form to first form, some amount of energy will be lost by the benzene. Okay, that is approximately 20 kilojoules per mole. That is called stabilization energy or resonance energy of benzene. When that energy is going to be lost, why it is losing the energy? Normally benzene we are expecting more energy, but because of existence of these resonance forms, benzene is going to lose the energy, then it is getting more stable. Okay ma'am, then it is getting more stable. Why it is getting more stable? Because double bonds are moving from one position to another position. Because of that only it is getting extra stability. Then that is not going to lose that extra stability. If addition reactions are taken place by or undergone by benzene, it is going to lose that double bond. One double bond is broken, resonance structures are not possible. Alternate single and double bonds are present, then only resonance structures are possible. If it is going to disturb that conjugation, even one bi bond is broken and it forms new bond, a sigma bond, then conjugation is not present, then it is going to lose the stability. That's why benzene is not undergoing addition reactions. Very drastic conditions only benzene will undergo addition reactions. In the chemical properties, I will show that one. Is it okay, ma? Now, continuation of this explanation of resonance, ma. See? While benzene is converting from one form to another form, this is structure 1 and this is structure 2, it is going to lose some energy which is called resonance energy. The molecule with less energy will be highly stable. If it is going to lose the energy, it has less energy. Correct or not? So it is getting extra stable. So benzene is more stable when compared to alkenes also. Benzene is more stable when compared to alkenes also because of this resonance stable energy. Why that resonance energy is happened? Because of resonance forms. That's why the molecule which contains high resonance forms, it will be highly stable. That point in note, you can note down. Now, again, I will tell the point before that. As benzene is moving from, shifting from one structure to another structure and another structure to this structure, some amount of energy is lost by benzene. That is called resonance energy or stabilization energy. Because of this energy lost by benzene, it is going to be extra stable. It is going to be extra stable. That's why we are writing one structure of benzene that is called resonance hybrid. What is that called? Resonance hybrid of benzene. Every single bond is getting double bond character, na? So it is shown like a circle. So while we are writing the reaction, sometimes a benzene cycle of hexagon ring with the circle also, it will be shown for benzene. This is nothing but resonance hybrid. Okay, because of this extra stability, benzene is not undergoing reactions like alkenes. Okay, it is undergoing some special type of reactions only. That one in chemical properties we will see. Okay ma, this is about resonance explanation of benzene, as well as why that benzene is more stable, why it is not undergoing addition reactions, because of this conjugation double bond. Now I think you understood in cyclopropanoyl ring. Now I will explain that one also. Let us see that one. Cyclopropanoyl ring does not contain double bond, next single bond, next again double bond is not present. But here, plus charge is present. That plus charge is going to fulfill the double bond character like that I told. It is going to show resonance. See, this is shifted like this. Then double bond is present here and positive charge is present here. This is going to shift here. Then positive charge is coming here. Not here. That bond is shifted here. Then double bond is coming here and positive charge is coming here. Again, this is shifting here to form this one. So structure 1, structure 2, structure 3. These are the three structures, resonance structures of benzene. Sorry, cyclopropanil cation. These are the three resonance structures of cyclopropanil. Why that conjugation is mentioned, did you understand now? Because of that conjugation, benzene-like compounds are getting extra stability. Okay, that extra stability cyclopropanil cation is gotten by resonance. Even though conjugation, double bonds and single bonds are not present, that positive charge present here in cyclopropanil cation, it is fulfilling the presence of double bond. Because of that, it is able to show resonance structures and it is getting extra stability like aromatic compounds. That's why it is also coming under aromatic compound only. All aromatic compounds are extra stable because they are able to show resonance structures. All aromatic compounds are extra stable because they are able to show resonance structures. Okay, ma? Not only resonance, planar structure as well as that Hückel's rule must be followed. Then only they will be stable and they are called aromatic compounds. This is the explanation regarding resonance of benzene, resonance forms of benzene. I hope everyone you are clear. Okay, every carbon undergoes sp2 hybridization, then it is with planar. It is planar in structure. Okay, ma? While this resonance form is converting from one form to another form, some amount of energy is lost. That is called resonance energy or stabilization energy. Okay, next. I told one note point for you. That note point is the molecule which contains more resonance structures will be highly stable. The molecule which contains more resonance structures will be highly stable. Okay, that point you can note down in the classwork. And resonance forms of benzene. What is the structure of benzene? That clockwise and anti-clockwise concept is very important to understand how pi electrons are moving from, pi bonds are moving from one position to another position. Okay, when the clockwise direction is reversing with anti-clockwise, this bond is shifted to next carbon. Like that, pi bond is shifting from one position to another position. Because of that shifting, that benzene is going to lose energy. Because of that losing of energy, benzene is getting extra stability. So all aromatic compounds, even though they contain double bond, they are getting extra stability when compared to alkenes. That's why they kept under one separate side heading. These are all aromatic hydrocarbons. Okay, ma? And this is about resonance structures of benzene. By this, what is the reason benzene is not undergoing addition reactions? How it is stable? How it is getting extra stable? And what about the resonance forms of benzene? All are explained in this class. Okay, now we are going through preparations of benzene and chemical properties of benzene as well as physical properties. If you are going to complete them, by that chapter is going to be completed. I hope two more classes we are going to complete this chapter, hydrocarbons. Okay, ma? This is about today's class. I hope everyone clear about the concept. Okay, if you have any sort of doubts, please ask me. I am ready to explain one more time also. No problem for me. Okay, ma? Thank you, all of you. Thank you all. Have a nice day.